Pisces, how you doing? So I'm pretty much done and finished with... Oh, okay, there you go. So there you are again. So we're going to leave that. We're not going to do any of the channeling stuff like that. I feel there's a lot of things that are being sun, the sun, the sun. Something to do with the sun, something to do with Dun, the name Dun, or Leo and the sun, and something's going on around the family. Could be a Capricorn. You probably want to watch the Capricorn reading. There are probably a few of you around that may not want to know what that is or may not like what's being heard or said or done. There is someone that is called Dun, Pucci, Stern, Jackson, all those kind of people are here. Capricorn's got a big place in it. Pisces, you definitely come up in the Capricorn reading. I would pretty much watch that. I'm not going to go into all this again. I'm hearing Jack, Jackson, Jackie, Dun, the name Dun. Things are done, things are hot, things are also warming up for some people around a Leo. A Leo could be warming up towards you. You could be with a Leo and that could be your partner. Warming up to something around the sun, looking for something better and hot, also looking for a location to move to if you physically are thinking about moving. You are looking for a new location in order to set up a business, they're saying. They're also hearing, I'm also hearing, mind your own business, this is done. There is something that is finished and done, but they keep saying done, the name Dun or Pucci or Jackson. But they definitely keep saying that looking for a better location, looking for a better location to live. You could really be having something to do with a Capricorn because they had looking for an extension or a granny annex or something like that that was put on an extension for the side of the house. I think a lot of you do have a lot to do with around Capricorn energies. It could have something to do with Ali, alchemy in you, and also Ali. There's a lot of things that have been going around the spiritual community. We've gone over it through Capricorn reading. A lot of crap, a lot of narcissism, a lot of control. A lot of things warming up though, they're saying though, Pisces, for some of you. Running over the same old ground. Digging for gold. Someone's a gold digger. They're digging for money, they're digging for information, and they're digging into someone's life. They're trying to find out what's going on in their life. Also coming up with some sort of clue that is coming up with someone else's. So someone else, the name Elsie or Effie or Effin Else, or someone from China. Something is going around, being spread around, as someone trying to pick up some kind of clue around gold digging, something that could be within the summit of something that someone could find, something very honourable or treasurable in, like a piece of land that they find. They might start digging and then they might start coming up against some kind of something that's in the ground, something that's in the floor. This would be, it. Say if you have a, I don't know, because we don't really have them so much here, when you dig outside and you need a sump hole, what do they call that, where everything, like a wash away or something like that. So you might find something in the ground if you start digging. Some of you are artifacts and looking for, some of it is facts, Jackson. Some of this is artifacts that you might find when you start digging. You might find out more than what you know. So a lot of you, you're going to find out a lot of clues and you might hear something that you don't like or find something within this when you dig for information. You're pretty much probably going to get something that you don't like to hear. Someone is also going to speak their mind, speak the truth. You've got something around Libra that could be coming out for a lot of you. Some sort of truth that is spoken of something that you might spoke in the wheel. I'm picking up another spokesman. Someone is a spokesman. Someone speaks, publicly speaking, and Spudley. The name Spudley? Dudley. Someone could be from Dudley or from Cannock. Hey, you're right there, lad. You're right there from Dudley. But yeah, someone could be from Down Under. Could be from Australia. Your name could be Pucci or Dun or Stern. But something to do with Dun. It's done. Darren, the name Darren or Aaron. Also Aaron. There's some sort of error. Correction. Someone's trying to correct something that they've done. They realise they've done it. And they've done it again. I don't know if this person's trying to correct their mistakes. Trying to backtrack and cover something up. Someone could well be deleting a load of things, trying to make out that it's not them, but they're trying to delete it. They're trying to uncover some sort of clue. They find out what that is, and they're trying to uncover it by covering it up. So you definitely got something around Libra energy, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, or Jupiter. Or something that is being covered up that someone doesn't want someone to know that they're looking into their ex. Someone has got with their ex. Someone has put a hex on someone. You could have definitely something to do with around Virgo. Someone putting their hex on them or someone putting their ex onto them. I need to get my ex onto you or I'm putting my ex. I'm putting a hex on you is definitely what I'm hearing. I'm going to put a hex on you and I'm also going to put you over to my ex. I'm going to send this to my ex. So people's exes. They're all been part of people's channel, exactly like Capricorn reading. You'll have to watch that one. And then people's exes are all gone from one channel, probably Goddess, Dragon, Girl. How you doing, girl? But something to do with that, you've gone from this channel to that channel to that channel to that channel. And this person that is now in the shadows is now part of everybody's channel. So this person is all over people's channel. So it's like, it's all over, it's all over, it's all over, it's all over, it's all over. It's all coming to a big conclusion of things being over. So some of you might get into an argument with your partner. You could be arguing a lot. There is also a thing where someone is also trying to cover up, and it could have to do with a Capricorn, of where someone has left like loads of messages everywhere and they realise that they're all being covered up or blocked. Someone doesn't like the fact that it's been blocked. It could be the narcissistic Pisces that said I wasn't a channeler and that I have no right in the community to do all that. Grow up, pull your lip over your head, punch yourself in the stomach, see how you get on. Something like that. So you've also got those energies, Pisces. For a lot of you, someone realises that they got blocked or they're trying to cover up things and they keep leaving messages everywhere but they realise that they are blocked. Or it's got a lot to do with around Capricorn, where people then all of a sudden start freaking out around their karma of realising that their ex could well know, or their son or daughter might know that they're talking with their ex. So then these people may start being on the chat here. They might start making a message and then delete it and cover it up because they think that their son or their daughter might be watching because they've done something that has pretty much put their son or daughter onto the clue that they might be doing it again. If they are doing it again, they probably freak out. They probably delete their message and start to realize that the ex could well be looking at what it is that I have posted online. This could be anything to do with around you or your partner. It could be an ex that's trying to get into that. It could be anything also to do with around Facebook, where people are putting things on Facebook in order to be seen, and then they realize that their family are also part of either one YouTube, Twitter, or Facebook, or YouTube, yes, and then thinking that their son or their daughter or these people might actually see the fact that they are seeing their ex or talking to their ex, or people are putting things on Facebook in order to get witnessed by their ex-partner trying to get their soulmate or their twin flame interested. This could be people that put music online trying to think that if I leave it public, I'm going to put some sort of weird clue online in order to get this person to realize what I am thinking and what I'm going through myself. And someone starts to put emotional music up on YouTube to try and think that is my partner going to be watching that and also feeling very sympathetic. They're saying simple Simon, something around the name Simon or around an Aries or around a channel. Sympathy, Cynthia, the name Cynthia. Cynthia says also sympathetic. They're saying I need sympathy. Also something around Gemini of having some sort of argument, I feel, for a lot of you around sympathy. The name Symphony, Simon, Symphony, some sort of symphony, grand ordeal, some sort of grand and a deal that could be exchanged around £1,000 for a lot of you. Someone could also be from Ireland. Ireland, I scold you, pot of gold, and it's from around Ireland. So I would see that as a grand. So something is grand. Someone is from Ireland. How are you getting on there down in Ireland? How's things going down there? It's a knot corner. No, a knot corner is not a corner. It's actually known as a Celtic cross. Some of you could be looking into doing anything that is Celtic. Anything also could be looking into witchcraft. A lot of you are into witchcraft. You believe in wrapping candles. You're probably thinking that your twin flame will be ignited to you by setting off some sort of witchcraft or some sort of binding spell is also what I'm picking up. People are into witchcraft, they're trying to get their twin flame to notice them, and that could be one way that a lot of you are trying to do that, is by doing witchcraft, or you sell it online, and you pretty much probably try and do this in order to, one, where you've got your twin flame watching, and that you do all this kind of thing, and you do it for other people, and you make candles, and you're either a Wiccan or a witch. That seems to be your channel messages, Pisces. How are you doing? If they don't relate to you, watch your Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, or leave a hate comment, and then go somewhere else. All right, Pisces, how you getting on? That seems to be that all wrapped up. So let's see. So Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, show me what's been going on in the past for Pisces. Coming straight out with, I have the power of a chest. Someone is sticking their chest out, and they're being brave in order to say something. That I am also one in the shadows, spying on people's channel, people's stuff. I'm trying to get people to see me, to watch me, to recognize me. But you could well be spying on someone here, Pisces, but there is someone that could also be watching you also. Or this person does know the fact that you are spying. But what it is, a lot of people seem to be curious about what's going on, but not actually speaking up. For a lot of you, you are maybe speaking to your person, but you could be ignoring a child or a parent, and you might not be on good wavelength with either sons or daughters if you have them, and you feel that that is the son or daughter that might be knowing what you're doing if you are talking to your past partner or ex. If you are talking to someone, you could be a daughter or son, and you are trying to also, or have been, trying to see your person and talk to your person, but not get the family member to know the fact that you are talking to them. Okay? So there's someone that you're trying to avoid, someone that you're trying to talk to and could well be, but try not to pay attention to anybody that you don't want to know about your secret desired relationship here. Let's see, Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus and Jupiter, what's been going on in the past with them? So you've got lovers, so it could be a Gemini. You could be the son of a daughter of a preacher man, or actually a Gemini is the grandparent or parent. Okay, and that would be the grand. This person might support you in certain ways. They might love you. You might love them, but you're also not speaking to them at the same time. You feel that they don't need to know your business of your love life, even though they are in your love life. You could also be a Gemini, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, or Jupiter, and you are a child with those placements, probably within your moon, and you are talking to your love life, but you are also avoiding the grandparent or parent to not let them know the fact that you are talking to your love life. So you are talking to someone, but you're also trying to avoid someone to let them know what you're doing in your love life, okay? So let's see, Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and Jupiter, what's been going on with them? So you've got this, beg and kneel. Kneel before me, kneel by mouth. Some of you could do this for a grandparent or a parent, and you look after the elderly, and it is more of a kneel by mouth situation. If it is not as a job, it's pretty much where a parent looks after you, you look after the parent, and you are cohabited as a unit of people that look after one another, but you coexist by not speaking. You probably realise that it's best to just get on with your own lives, but actually live and coexist, but not get on. There is someone that begs for someone's attention to speak to them, but they don't want to. This person is also looking at a treasure, something that is treasury, the treasury of a company. Some of you could own your own company and you are the treasurer of that. Okay, I'm also hearing Trevor. What's up, Trevor? Trevor. Let's see. Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus and Jupiter. Four. Show me the past, what's been going on with Scorpio. Four. That's why I said it. But you're not a channeler, Steve. No, I have no idea, so I don't know what you're watching. But anyway, you will wind yourself up the more you keep doing that, person. But there is nothing standing in your way in order to speak your truth. This is very private and it's very personal. I have a private life and I have a personal life, and nobody really should be standing in my way, even though I feel that they are. I feel that I can't go forward on my projects and on my desires because I find it very personal. Okay, so someone takes things very personal. The last thing that you want to do is wind someone like me up that has a Scorpio rising. Don't wind me up. You will get a backlash and you will get a sting, stern and done. Okay, but there you go. So there is someone that is not there. They don't have a relationship because the Hierophant is not there. So there's nothing that is stopping you seeing this person. This person, though, here does want to know about your relationship. But I feel because the Hierophant is physically not in this deck, that you try to keep them out of your relationship and out of your personal life. You have hit a milestone in your life, but you find this person finds it very private, very personal, and keep out, stay out my energy, don't ask. The answer is no. Okay? So that might be what's been going on in your love life, but generally around your family situation. So a lot of you are trying to get noticed. You're trying to get this person to pay attention to you here. If you're in a great standing relationship, you are in it. Okay, this came out for a Capricorn reading. This person is in the shadows of trying to offer this person something to try and get their attention focused. But this is a king. So this is going to take no tit for tat energy of not speaking and just spying. If you want something, then ask for it. And if you don't, piss off, pretty much. But this is, well, I don't even know the fact that you are behind me. This is not a Punch and Judy show of like, oh, yes, they are. Oh, no, they're not. Yes, they are. No, they're not. Yes, they are. No, they're not. To me, to you, to me, to you. So here it is, more of an opportunity to offer someone a relationship, a love interest, or to keep someone out of it because they don't even know that this cup is magically behind them, of some sort of magic that could be here. Okay. But definitely Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. I'm not speaking. I've got two children, maybe. I'm trying my best to be a father. Some of you are a single father. Okay, and you're doing your best to raise your children here. you could have two children as a father, and you as a Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, and you don't speak to your children, and they do their mum, or they don't speak to anybody. I don't know. There's a very strange energy here of people speaking and not speaking, people that are sitting in the shadows, not actually saying anything, feeling intimidated, probably by a very strong character that would be a death card, and also Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. It could be double Scorpio, could be double Pisces. But again, double trouble of people having to approach this king, but a lot of people won't here, or haven't been honest here, or someone feels that this person isn't being honest. Let's see, Page of Swords is the sun. So a lot of you've got things going on around your actual sun. Okay, but you are maybe the sun that is seeing a Leo. If you are seeing a Leo and you are the sun, and it's the same representation of the channel messages and the message that you might be trying to avoid someone to not tell them about what's going on in your love life, that will be representing the person that is in the family that you are trying to avoid to tell the fact that you are seeing either one, two people, or that you are witnessing and seeing one of these people, but you don't want the family member to know the fact that you are seeing someone, right? That would be you hovering over the idea of the Page of Swords, of not speaking to the family member to let them know where you're at. You might still have the energy that was channeled where trying to cover that up to avoid this person to not let them know the fact that you are seeing someone. The Lovers, what's the Lovers? The Lovers and the Mothers, you've got Sagittarius energy. Everything is completely up in the air of around that person. This mother or this grandfather, this could be a Gemini, Sagittarius, an older person where everything is up in the air with them. You don't know where this is going to land, okay? You don't know if you're going to land a deal also. If this is physical land, and this was representing the Capricorn reading that was done, and that was the done, there you go. If that was representing the Capricorn reading that was done and it was an X, then that was relating to this deck though, where there was the Ten of Wands that was representing land extension, okay, and that is representing that, where everything is up in the air at the moment to do with the granny annex that is on the side of a house, to not let this person know or to try and avoid them to get out of the house and get away from it, or build a granny annex or build an extension on the side of the house so you can get out the family home. This is the family home, this is the granny annex or the veranda that is built on the side of a house that you escape from to go into, okay? Page of Wands, begging for attention, definitely around Capricorn energy here. This person is blocked, this person gets loads of attention, these people are begging this person for attention. Okay, so that is also an attention seeker, because in the Page of Wands, that is someone that is not letting themselves know because they are blocked out of their life. So you might find it very difficult to get into your child's life if you have them, because they may have blocked you out. They may have realized something about you getting attention somewhere else. They probably don't like it or something like that. And this person isn't speaking if you're not speaking to children. Four of Pentacles, what is that for? But that is someone that is emotionally and physically blocked. And that is someone that gets quite a lot of attention here. Depends who they want to pay attention to. Four of Wands, something to do with the Pisces, another one maybe. That could be you that is physically blocked, that's trying to keep someone out of your life, or they are you. Alchemy and you also, probably. But the Ten of... this person is blocked also. Or trying to block people out of their channel, maybe. I don't really know. The Death card is Sagittarius for me. But Queen of Wands... Well, I feel optimistic about my future. I don't know about you. I know that I can go whichever way that I want, with or without you. But I keep hearing you. Alchemy and you, probably. Don't know. Queen of Wands, Seven of Swords. Something very devious around this person. This person is also a seven, which is also bent over backwards, running backwards and forwards. Someone saying, do you want to? How, where, how? This is... Foxy lady, this person, these people are begging for this attention for their hand in marriage, maybe, or bent over backwards doing everything for you here. But this person here, Seven of Swords, they're trying to get the hell out of it very fast. This person can run a lot of errands. This person is bent over backwards doing everything for everybody here. Okay, could be someone in the family, could also be another Pisces here. Pisces, Scorpio, like my rising, also a Pisces, but bent over backwards. Someone's trying to deceive this person, and they know damn well that they're trying to do it, and they're trying their best to avoid these people that are causing a lot of conflict. Okay. Seven of Swords. I speak truth. People don't like it. Six of Swords. Something in the family. Okay. Something in the family. Got quite a lot of swords there. Is trying to find something better. Someone who's very frivolous and they like to do things the correct way and not the wrong way. This is, I need to do it the right way, not the wrong way. You could have children. This could be your family. Someone is trying to give someone a helping hand. Okay. To find a different place to live here, because you might have to go from here to here. So trying to find somewhere else to stay. You might go and visit your partner if you're with one, and what you avoid is the family drama and the family karma there, and you try to get out of that and move away. You've been going towards the King of Cups, which is your love interest here. So you're in a relationship mainly, Queen of Pentacles, King of Cups, the Fool. The Fool. So there you go. Definitely a big time around Capricorn energy. That's what they had. This is a mother or a father as children here. These two are more than likely together, which is the Queen of Cups, the King of Cups and the Queen of Pentacles. Those two to me are the family, and that's a grown-ass man with a woman, and that'd be a mother. Okay, and this would be the child, which could be the grown-ass parent person here. And they're not a child, they're just the child of a person. Okay, that's not a young child. This person could also have a young child, though. That would also be your love life if you're in a committed relationship. That's you and your partner. Okay, could be an earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, somewhere in their chart. You could be the Pisces there. You've got a new beginning. You've been trying to escape this to go and see this person and not talk to this person to let them know the fact that you've been doing that. Something is being hidden from people, from children or parents, to not let them know that you're in a relationship. Here, Pisces. So that's your past. Let's have a look to see what you've got coming up for your for December for Pisces. I've already shuffled this deck, Pisces. Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus and Jupiter. Five of Coins, something going on around the family. Some sort of child support or maintenance needed by ex-father or ex marks the spot around Capricorn. Leaving someone, okay, this could be that I leave the house to go and see my partner and I try to avoid the family situation at home in order to go and see the person, so you go from home to home, from place to place. This could be your children, if you've got an ex, they go from one place to another, they go to see you, they go home, they leave you, they leave them, they leave you is what I hear. You, or yo-yo, backwards and forwards like a yo-yo. Someone, let's see, so Pisces, Submarine Rising, Venus and Jupiter for December 2020. Happy Christmas, narcissist. There you go. There you go. Something around a Virgo, maybe. Here, search and destroy. So you got someone that likes it and then destroys it. That wants it, then destroys it. That wants it, but doesn't want it. Someone is very controlling in your energy, Pisces. Who knows who that is, right? There you go. So it could be someone at home, could be a mother here. Someone definitely who you live with, you may see it as the other person. They may also see that that's you as well. That's why you are not on the same wavelength. You realize that there is no talking or getting through to you, because you always try to make me believe that there is something in it that isn't. Okay, so a lot of you, if you're really struggling in a relationship, someone's trying to make you believe there's a relationship, but it physically isn't. Again, there could also be a Virgo energy here. It could be someone that is suffering through PTSD and traumatized by an experience of the whole lot of going between their house, your house, your house, their house. Okay, this is my house. Something to do with someone being very demanding, saying, no, this is my house, you do what I want. This is my house, you don't own it. Okay, or it's something to do with ownership of things. I own this, you don't own it. I own the rights, no, I don't, you do. You could be fighting with the government here in some ways of trying to get the ownership of an actual house or property, if there is property value there, trying to fight the government maybe, or the parent of who has the right to this Five of Pentacles. Who has the right to know about my life? Who doesn't have the right to know about my life? Some of you are in a very narcissistic, controlling relationship itself. Let's see. Pisces, Sun, Rising, Venus and Jupiter. So some of you have got metaphysical connection and you feel the bitch is the other person that is the bitch. And you think that the person that you have the karma that comes back to you if you have a spiritual connection. A lot of people that have a spiritual connection with someone, they're the people that can go quite crazy because they realize that you have the spiritual connection, which all happens up in your head. You believe everything that you see and hear. You take everything into consideration. You're probably taking way too much information. And then the spiritual connection is the person that runs around because they have it all in their head. And then they wonder, why is it that it's not coming together? Because there's too much thinking. There is also parents here that think too much. There's someone also that wants to know about someone's Two of Cups relationship, because there would be someone that's in a relationship. That's why the Two of Cups would be here of a metaphysical connection. That can also be parents that tried to find out about a physical six, even though the 5-6 isn't here, it's a two. It's more of a metaphysical connection that people have with them that are on a spiritual journey of a trigger. Some of you have got a very narcissistic controlling trigger here by a Two of Cups, by a person that searches and then destroys, searches it, destroys it, searches it, destroys it. Someone could be very non-committal. Someone here could set up loads of soulmate relationships. They pull them all together and they realize, oh, I'm not ready. Now, I get my Two of Cups as soon as I've got it. No, I'm not ready. I've just triggered it off and messed it all up. Because your personal growth is leading you more and more and more deeper into the further of control of where your metaphysical connections are defined by your past. You will trigger off every future and past and present if you are currently in a real big bowl of soup here. Okay. Because someone gets triggered off by loads of things, they start getting very intimidated or feeling intimidated. They feel as if they're backed into a corner. They overthink and then they project that onto their metaphysical connection or their partner. And they project that onto the Six of Cups, if that physically is here. Okay? Of worry, stress. Let's see. Pisces, something rising from Venus and Jupiter for December. So, Three of Pentacles, a lot of you could well be in a controlled environment of three, which is a drama triangle. You never really break out of those. As soon as you break out of it, you go straight back into another one with another person, which can also be a mother, lover, hater. Okay, I'm also hearing the name hater, or people have got haters here. So you've got 5, 6, 7, 8 of Pentacles. It's a lot to do also around Leo, I feel, for a lot of you. Aquarius, Leo. Some of you are having to go to court for an ex here. You're having to go, this is something very religious, I'm feeling. Very religious. Something possibly Jewish or something like that I'm picking up. Someone's very religious. Someone's also very stern here. But you've got the Queen of Cups. Someone doesn't know what love is. Because someone is constantly being controlled and they don't know what love is. Someone's very uncommittal. It's coming across exactly the same as it was in the Capricorn reading. Someone's very uncommittal. They don't want a relationship. Or they do, and they call people in to tell them to piss off. It's really what I'm picking up. Believe me or not. But it's like, as soon as I've got it, I'll destroy it. Because I'm trying to destroy your life. Someone's trying to destroy someone's financial career. Or like anything that anybody does as a job. They feel that someone's trying to destroy their career. Or make them feel like they can't say anything. Or that they can't do anything. Defined by their past of control relationships. Pisces. One more card, please. So you've got Capricorn, there you go. So a lot of you are dealing with around a Capricorn. Some of this could be dealing with a Virgo, that is to deal with witchcraft. I put hex on you, that's what Capricorn had. If I didn't say it, it's because I had to delete it 5 times because this same circumstance that was coming up. There was a lot around done, Jackie, Jackson, all that sort of stuff, but there you go. So you've got the devil there. So you've got a very toxic, narcissistic person around you, big time, that could really relate to people defined by their past karma within not being able to say anything online. If you run anything online on a business of Facebook or YouTube, it's this feel that people that are behind the shadows, knocking people off to control it, to make them loopy, and to make them feel like they're confined by something that is very toxic, that is trying to stop them from being honest. So there you go. So you have exactly the same channel messages. I'm apparently not a channeler by that person, but whatever. But again, the past that we channeled, the past stuff that we looked at within the past cards, is also someone like that is trying to stop someone and implanting things into their head. And if they're not implanting into their head, they're psychically trying to stay in the shadows to do that, to make this person feel as if they are defined by karma, because the devil is never seen and neither is God. It's just something that is felt, okay? So this, if you listen too much to the devil, this person, not this person, I'm just saying something can put this in your head to make you believe it, which means there's control here of things that are people in the shadows that are feeling like they're restricted by people implanting themselves into someone's head by doing very narky, narcissistic things that try to actually stop people from doing or saying or being whatever they want. Stern, if you're watching this and this has come back to bite you on the ass, well, there you go. There's your karma right there. Of the stuff that happened over there, the stuff that you'll persistently do here, the reason why that isn't working out over there, if it isn't, is because you're controlling. It's because this person, you're seeing them as the controlling one, when really, you're both controlling each other. You're both as bad as one another. What happened to me is now happening to you. You're in a karmic bind here of something that you feel like you can't get out of, that you are physically restricted in your head, that you can't let this person know that you're doing it. And even though you are doing it, you're refined by your karma that is now persisting to tell you exactly the same thing of what you owe back. By what you've done to someone else, you are now done the same thing again. This person more likely now is making you feel intimidated that you can't do exactly what you want. So there you go. There's your pattern that came between the pattern of the Capricorn reading. So a lot of things that are also happening. This is an emotional manipulation of people manipulating people's emotion to not let them say or do whatever they want on their own channel. If they have their own channel or they have their own public site, there's someone that tries to manipulate that to not let them be or do or express anything that they want to within their own life. Of someone that tries to implant things in their head karmically to make them feel restricted that they are not able to say or do exactly what they want, even though they may know. And that is representing the stuff that came out through Capricorn of people wanting to be seen. Exes, twin flames, people that have all been guided towards people's channel, gone from one channel to another, or you're an actual person that used to have a twin flame, or used to have a soulmate connection, that used to be a six that is now a two, of someone that is now psychically trying to play some kind of psychic warfare game, a very childish game of combatant energy of I'm going to implant all this even though you know I'm not going to let it know, I stay in the shadows. Page, I am sitting in the shadows, not letting it known, even though I'm blocked. And then your karma comes back to bite you on the ass. If you have done anything to implant that on something, then you have to undo that to get it off. You have to not pay any attention, and you have to call these people out and exactly who they are. So what you've got is don't hide from people, don't hide from your karma, don't fear it, don't worry about saying stuff. If you want to face your own reality and you want to face facts and you want to say it, then you have to speak up and let it be known exactly and be honest to this also person here that they are you or you are doing that in order to represent, to stand up as a normal, sane human being, to admit your karma, not fear it, not sit in the shadows, to let yourselves be known and to stand up and be a grown-up ass adult and stand up for what it is instead of sitting in the shadows knocking people off. That can either be you or the other person, but if the karma has come back to bite you, to confuse you, it's because something that you did in the past that is now representing your future. Your future is now defined by your past of mistakes that you are now having to rectify of things that you've done to other people in the past. Done. So once you've done that, then you'll stay in this bind forever by thinking that each other is doing it to one another, even though you don't know. That is your reading so far, Pisces. Thanks very much, guys. We're going to go over to Patreon. If you want to join, you will see the rest of your reading. This will go to Tier 1 and also the Full Access Bundle. If you are part of the Full Access Bundle, then that is where you will get both bi-weekly readings that don't appear anywhere else. You will also see your Life Path reading, your extended that goes there also. But when we do your bi-weekly readings, we do a full spread that doesn't come out anywhere else. We clarify them, and then we look into your partner or the other people that are representing in your life that you want to know about. So that will then tell you what's going on in their life, their thoughts, their feelings. If you are thinking that someone else is indicative with someone else, then you really just have to watch your Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus and see it from the other person's perspective of when we do your spread and then the others and what's going on in their life. If those same circumstances match up, then you pretty much can put those pieces together yourself and figure it out. So you get majority of that stuff over on the Full Access Bundle. If you would like to reach out for a personal reading or anything like that, all of my links are below for emails and that kind of stuff. If anybody has also given over anything to do with GoFundMe or anything like that, I really do appreciate it. Thank you so much, and I'll hopefully see you over on Patreon, Pisces.